Okay, I promise to keep this short, but I cannot resist the opportunity to introduce you to Mariana Fortuny, one of my favorite dudes in theater history. All right, Mariana Fortuny is an Italian inventor, artist, designer, innovator, whose work really made a big impact in multiple areas of the arts, not just one. That's why he's so cool. He lives 1871 to 1949, and he is so many things. He's a painter, a musician, a textile designer, a photographer. These are all examples of his work here on this page. He is a couture fashion designer who created something called the Delphos dress. He created these beautiful handmade pleats, and he patented this technique. It was a secret, this technique. His dresses had these long handmade pleats, and the pleats were weighted by glass beads, and that helped the pleats to hold their shape, and it made them sort of follow the contours of a woman's body more closely. It was a simple, elegant design, but also felt very, very modern. People went nuts for the Delphos dress. It was very fashionable to have a Delphos dress. The pleats that he made are still in the garments. They're beautifully preserved, and his garments are on display in fashion institutes and garment history exhibits around the world. And nobody knew how to do this. It was a secret. How he designed and executed his particular method was a secret, and nobody managed to replicate what Fortuny did with his pleats until like the 1980s. So he's a very interesting guy. He also was, as I said, an inventor, and he got interested in inventing things for stage lighting. Also, his applications were useful for photography, but he got interested in it, and he was a photographer, but he got interested in this through stage lighting. He went to the theater. He was a guy who saw plays. That was what you did in the period, and he was very cultured, so he saw a lot of theater, and he was annoyed at certain qualities of the light. He thought that the lights, because of open flame, right? Look at the dates, the beginning of when he's doing this. He saw a lot of things that were using gas light and then electric light. But the lights could go out and they could flicker if it was open flame. And that bothered him. Even when we got rid of the open flame, there was inconsistency with color that he thought could be better. And he was aware of how they added color to both gas lights when those existed and to electric lights, which was by dipping glass into dye. They would then put that glass in front of the light, but the heat would cause the pigment to burn away, and that would make the color less intense and also inconsistent, and they have to be re-dipped. So he thought, there must be a better way to do this, guys. Also, because he had this eye of a painter and an artist, he really did not like the quality of compositional effect, let's say that, of footlights and top lighting, which is what was being used, right? We didn't really talk about this in the previous lectures, but candlelights used top light and footlight, right? We know that. Well, when they got gas light and then electric light, they did not immediately innovate where they put the lights. Yeah, we have spotlights, that helps with some fill, but they really did not get better at placing light fixtures to provide light in ways that were more complex for another few decades. So what Mariana Fortuny would see was this really flattened stage picture, whether it's gas lights or electric, this really flattened stage picture that is a result of using just footlight and top light, you know, not having enough side light and not having fill light. So he thought we should be able to do better than this, and he invented something called the Fortuny light. And that's a Fortuny light. You may have seen something like this in a photographic situation before, because it is applied in photography and is still used. An element like this is still used, but he invented it. And it's an indirect lighting source. So you have an instrument box, and the lamp faces away from the audience. Light hits silk inside, bounces back towards the stage. That makes light that is diffused more complementary. more sculptural to the body. See, look at that. On the left, what you see is looking into the domed fixture, and there's a light source in there, and then there is fabric, and the light is hitting that, and it is bouncing off of that onto whatever you want to illuminate. This diffuses the light. It creates more fill and diffusion, which is sculptural light, more complementary and more three-dimensional. He invented that. And then, and that was used in theater and in photography. And then he had this crazy idea. You could make basically a ginormous Fortuny light. It's like a permanent cyclorama that's domed behind the stage. It's called a Fortuny dome. And there's a metal frame, big metal frame. Look at that. I know it's kind of blurry. Look at that picture. Big metal frame. Dome covered in layers of silk. A fan blows in the silk so that it pushes it out and smooths it out. And then you light the silk. You hit the lights back towards the back of the theater. It hits that silk and then it diffuses forward and creates beautiful diffused light, but also makes for a sort of optical illusion of tremendous depth and expanse. And it was a great way to make a realistic sky with this dome light, because the eye couldn't tell where it ended. There's no corners or edges. Here are some of his drawings for how to do it. And these were made and installed in theaters. Can you believe people building this? But they did. Some places even made it permanent and plaster. They called it a plaster dome. In German, they called it a Kuppelhorizont. And they would install these in small theaters to make them look bigger. This is invented by Mariano Fortuny. And I'm telling you what, how cool is this guy? Can I just tell you four of the things he invented? I cannot get enough of him. All right, he invented the first working color scroller because he thought the way of dipping glass into dye to get color on lights was really so ineffectual. He figured out you could put colored fabric on a scroller, turn the scroll, change the color of the light, but also turn it to another color with just changing the scroll. So we call that a color scroller. He invented a grid bridge so that electricians could do their work. So he invented catwalks for electricians to go up and do their work. That didn't exist before. They'd have to lower it or they used ladders. He came up with the idea to have light poles fly up and down for better maintenance. And he created what he called a director's booth. We'd call it a stage manager's booth at the back of the stage so that the light board off could see the stage instead of being in the wings. He's just a really cool guy. He also painted this beautiful picture. Isn't it great? Mariano Fortuny, right? Isn't he interesting? Do you see why I couldn't resist myself? I just really need you to know about him. Renaissance man of the theater, really invented cool stuff. We owe a lot to him, but he's not a household name. I'm glad you met him, Mariano Fortuny. All right, that ends our unit on lighting. Have fun with your online quizzes, and I will see you at the Little Theater Movement in a couple of days. Bye.